So let's have a look in a ceiling rose. So again, we're used now to seeing the colours being the old colours, so red and black replacing our new ones, which are brown and blue. Fantastic, the switching line conductor, which is black. So down to the switch, they've taken a red and a black, but the black isn't being used as a neutral. It's being used as a switching line conductor and is identified like so, and is in this block of two here. We've got the centre loop section here where there's actually four red conductors in there. So obviously they've taken an extra one off, maybe a loft light. And that means we've got three neutrals in here as well and our CPCs. So the looping terminal here has our permanent line connection, our neutral connections over here, and our switching line conductor, which is a black cable with red sleeving in order to identify as a switching line conductor in the CPC. So that's what we've got going on in the ceiling rows. So here we've got a one gang switch. And then we turn it over, it's got common L1 and L2, and that's being used as a one-way switch. So it's common practice on site not to use one-way switches like we do at college, but actually use a one-gang two-way switch, but use it as a one-way. So we look here, we've got the red common, we've got black, which is a switching line identified with red sleeving. It's gone in L2, and we've got our CPC secured to the back box. If you happen to put it on and down is off and up is on, it's just a simple case of just turning it round, okay, so you get it thrown the right way. So this one gang two-way switch is being used as a one-way switch in this system.